And how we doing, everybody? Welcome back. It has been too long, almost 2 weeks. So let's get back into it. South Carolina 1-1, number 9 in the country, dropped pretty far after losing to Alabama in the first game. Came back, beat LSU our last time we played. It'll take me a minute to kind of remember everything here. Look at this recruiting. We struggle with LSU. We're able to pull away late, but now we got to, oh yeah, Hayden Hurst, Bruce Ellington, and our favorite drunk and quarterback. And I think we had to cut some people. Okay, yeah, we'll get back into this. We got all our points settled. We play the Puppy Dogs of Georgia, who have always given me trouble. I think we had the 3 overtime game. We had the one we had to come back from 18 down. I think last season we, and Lola's standing on top of the laptop. Thanks, Lola, for contributing. The last time we played Georgia, we had to score with like 5 seconds left to beat them. Look at Herbie picking us. I think we have Kevin Harris back for this game, so let's go ahead and get into it. I think we're going to go big game Garnet here. Yeah, let's do that. I don't really care what Georgia wears. So, back on the Luke Doty Heisman campaign. See if he can throw 26 interceptions this year. I think we already have 5. So, if Blake is here and he hears me, he's already probably going to win the over. Blake, speaking of devil, my man, what is up, buddy? What is up? Welcome back. Right on cue, right when I'm talking about interceptions, my man shows back up. Lola, get off the laptop. She is like fired up. We're streaming. How you been? I've been good. Going through some little personal stuff. That's why I ain't really streamed. And we're good now. Everything's good. I had to find the right time to get on and come back and stream. I apologize. I talked to Ryan on here last night. He messaged me. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA. No, I didn't quit. NCAA Football 14 pregame show. Lola, I can't take the cat right now. She's about to freak out. Of course, it's raining. No, I didn't quit. I just had some things I had to sort out in my mind. Lola, I swear to God, cat. Took so long I couldn't remember my Twitch username or password. I had to reset stuff. Look at that. Well, I'm glad you're here. I'm glad everybody's here. I know everybody wants to see some football. Like I said, Ryan messaged me the other day asking, you know, what was up. And I thought about it. I was like, you know, I just needed to find the right time to come back strong.
We're in Columbia, the capital of South Carolina. And folks,
let's see. We're going to talk about setting a set schedule. I don't think we're going to do every day like I was doing because I think I got kind of burnt out doing that. I think we'll do like maybe three, four days a week. You know, we're going back to work and everything. I'm not going to be able to do it every day. But I think we'll set like a schedule and we'll get into it. I'm going to incorporate this and Madden. I tried that NBA Live. I couldn't do it, man. They just got to play within themselves. Sometimes you get it. I got my tail kicked. A little bit too fired up at the beginning of the game. I agree with you. Spurs up. My Spurs up guy. You hit me up on Twitter. A little bit because they're trying so hard. When was this? Keep this home crowd in the game, and cuz I'm still pretty active on Twitter. So excited. Sometimes you force the play. Let's let the play naturally come to you and react to it. So we'll see if all right, let's get back into the Luke Doty Heisman campaign. They just let the game come to them. Oh, yeah, and okay, I get stuck. Kevin Harris is back last week. Okay, I have to look into that. I don't remember. Oh, my.
All
right, let's we got to get back into this because this is going to take me a minute to remember this game now. Chris is everything you said he was. Oh, you're talking to Blake. I thought you were talking to me. Hike the ball.
Going deep. Lays it up.
Ah! I had two of them open. Y'all, give me a few possessions to get this going, because I have been playing a little bit of Madden the past week or so, and it's going back and forth. It's going to get to me a little bit, so just give me a possession or two. You want to talk about a game that cheats? It's all Madden. That game, I don't know if you guys play Madden 20, but that game has, when you play like your franchise on all Madden, it has a hidden setting. I'm not making this up. It has a hidden setting that when you're up by like 7 or 10 points and you're driving to put the game away, you automatically fumble. It doesn't matter who it is, if you get hit, if you slide, if you get touched. Okay, really, Georgia's going to run the option too. You are going to fumble. They're going to recover it, probably run it back for a touchdown, or they're going to block a punt or something like that. Something happens. Told you he's the only one streaming Carolina sports. Well. Okay, first game back playing an option team. Is everybody in the SEC going to be option now? I'm not sure where Ryan is. I told him I was probably going to be on today. I just didn't know a time yet. There we go. I'm glad everybody's here. Everybody's fired up. Everybody's glad to be back. Get on him. Okay, God, Birch takes the guy, and he's open. Nah! Birch, you see Birch just knocked this kid down? He streamed a week or so ago, because I watched a tiny bit of it. He tried to stream that 2K, and then I looked back, he was gone. If it gets down at the one... Too much leg into that. Okay, I was about to be done if that got down at the one, guys. And we've seen some early film on him. Kirk and I, you know, we looked at it. He looks legit, but we'll see if it translates to real competition. This is a fun game. And I should have probably run the ball. Oh, wow. Got him all the way across the field. Welcome back, boys and girls. Dak Joyner. I did not want to throw that, but he was that wide open, you don't have a choice. Welcome back. And not to take anything away from the quarterback, but the wide receiver made this play. That receiver was so wide open as a quarterback. Just so we're clear, you never throw it back across the entire field like that unless he is that wide open and you got the arm. Let's go, boys. We are back. Nice job of staying in rhythm, making the easy throw and the touchdown. Let's hit it. Reese Davis is standing by. Glad you're back. Thank you, Blake. I appreciate that, buddy. Good to be back. I think part of it is I was getting a little too burnt out. I did that to myself, along with some other stuff. But let's get into it. So, you know, it's been a little bit of time. What the heck is up with Tennessee recruiting, man? Like, every day I looked online. Every day, like, I look online, Tennessee's getting a new recruit. And I mean, like, some actual decent recruits. We're not talking about, like, 2 and 3 stars. We're talking about 4 stars. They're highly sought after guys. Like, Tennessee is destroying in recruiting. This is not good for... This is not good for, Will Muschamp. Because one of the things that allowed us to get to those 11-2 seasons is the fact that Tennessee was down. You know, okay. You know, Florida was down. Well, Will Muschamp was there, except for the 1 year. And, I mean, that's what really allowed us to win the East, finish second in the East, go 6-2 in the conference, and really challenge for the East. A big part of that was beating Tennessee, because Tennessee – oh, my, it's an easy touchdown. Yeah, there we go, defense. Way to go, defense. Way to go, defense. But, like, that's what really allowed South Carolina to step into that second and third spot in the East. And then, of course, we fell back down losing to Kentucky 5 straight years. But Tennessee, if Tennessee is returning back to how they were when I was in high school and when I was growing up, that is not a good thing for South Carolina, considering Georgia, you know, is recruiting on another world. Florida looks like they're on the up with Mullen. Even though I think they're not an 11-2 team, but, you know, that is what it is. Every drive's important in a tie game. I just feel like that's not a good thing for South Carolina moving forward, even if, you know, Will Muschamp turns it on and we... Now he's scrambling. Oh, no! I didn't mean to do that. Wow, I did not mean to do that. The Gamecocks have one of the most dangerous Fire Muschamp. Weapons in the entire country under center today. This kid is really fun to watch. He's fun to watch unless you're a defensive coordinator. Fire Muschamp already, huh? It's going to be a great chess match between the offensive. Everybody's fired up about having no fans in the stands. From their own 20-yard line. There you go. Pay that $20 million buyout, yeah. Exactly. Look, I said it when he got that buyout. Whoever gave him that buyout should have been fired immediately in terms of, like, sanity. Because there's no reason. He had a 9-4 season, which, let's just be honest, we didn't beat anybody worth a crap. So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. You throw 100 towards it. I think the funny thing is that people would actually... you got to hold that block. People will actually donate money to get that buyout. That's just where we are. Run the Tater. There you go. We need Kevin Harris back. This is what hurt me in that Bama game. I mean, there were a lot of other factors in that game, the reason we lost, but I remember one of the things was Kevin Harris got hurt, and I started getting nervous and shied away from the running game too much. Oh, you got to hold the block, Sydney. Yeah, the defenders. There's always going to be defenders. We could go 0-12, and people would say, oh, he needs more time. Muschamp will be here 10 years. I mean, he needs more time, guys. It's not fair. And they make the stop at the 36-yard line. Yeah, he gets this year. This is it. There is no more excuses. I'm sorry. There is no more excuses. We've got a first and 10. People said he needed his team. He needed his guys. He inherited a mess. It's all Spurrier's fault. And, okay. Oh, what a block. Makes it to the 21. I wish I could have got by him. But yeah, I agree. I mean, it's do or die for Muschamp. I mean, he's done well on the recruiting tour. He said all the right things. But you got to get it done on the field. It's got to translate on Saturdays. Has to translate on Saturdays. Second down at 7 coming up here. Ball on the 18. Does a 7-6 save him? It depends. Now he tries to buy some time. Do you see how... Oh! 1 of 5. Wow. God. I don't know. 7-5. I mean, 7-5. So basically you're saying... You're saying 6-6 with a bowl win. Let's call it. What a catch! I didn't know he was going to cut out like that. Who's this Howell kid? So we'll say 7-6 is what you're saying. So that would mean, let's say for that purpose, they beat Coastal, which I think everybody agrees they should win that game. If they don't, Muschamp should go ahead and pack his stuff up, you know, when leaving the stadium. They should beat East Carolina, beat Missouri, beat either Tennessee or Kentucky, right? That's 4, and beat Vandy and Walford. That's 6-6. And I would be happy if they gave a good showing against Georgia, A&M, and Clemson. But if you win those, you scrape by and barely win those games, muscle. How'd he not get in? But if you barely win a few of those games, lose to Kentucky, get obliterated by Florida, Clemson again, LSU, so on and so forth, and you get destroyed in the big games, go to a bowl game and lay an egg, or you know, barely scrape by beating some scrub team or whatever. The sad thing is yeah, he probably does survive, because people are gonna say, well, because I mean, it's an improvement over 4-8. Anything's an improvement over 4-8, but that doesn't really show progress to me. Because he goes 6-6, that means he probably beat who everybody expected us to beat. I mean, he's got Missouri, Tennessee, and Vandy at home. Well, I mean, that's the thing. LSU's going to drop because nobody's going to replace Burrow, because, I mean, Burrow just, yeah. They still have talent. I mean, they lost a lot in that draft. They still got talent. They did lose that coordinator, Brady. I think LSU's still going to be good. But I think I've said this before. This is A&M's time. Like, this is A&M's chance. They're paying Jimbo Fisher too much money. You know, Bama lost Tua, lost a lot of the receivers. A lot of people think Saban doesn't have much longer. LSU loses a lot of stuff. If Jimbo and A&M are going to take that step, they better do it this year. That's my opinion. I mean, you can think what you want about Kellen Mond and all that, but this they're paying him way too much money to finish like 4th in the West. And you still got Mississippi State with Mike Leach. You got Lane Kiffin at Ole Miss. The West is going to be tough. But there's no super dominant team. Yeah, I mean, LSU's not going to have nowhere near that kind of offense again. They still got Jamar Chase, but you lost Justin Jefferson. They lost Jefferson. They lost a running back that went to Kansas City. Obviously lost Burrow. They lost a few pieces, Delpit and Queen on defense. I mean, they lost a lot of pieces. It's going to be impossible to replicate that. LSU will still be a 9-win team, I bet. LSU still got plenty of talent. Yeah, yeah. I forget that too. Yeah, Mike Leach went to Mississippi, which was just kind of out of nowhere. Some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. I'm curious to see how his offense works in the West. Okay. He's at midfield. Get by him, Luke. Yes. Yeah, Mike Leach and Lane Kiffin in the SEC West should be interesting. Two really great characters. Looking to capitalize on the big run. Now it's 1st and 10. South Carolina. Yeah, I know a lot of people on Gamecock Central really wanted Mike Leach. I had X, but we're taking a chance. Ah! Yep, that's what I get. That's what I get. Yeah, I didn't see the defender, Herbie. There's one. There's the one. I should have just hit X. He was wide open. Leach has never won that big game. Well, you could say the same thing about Mississippi State, too. Oh, my. Because, I mean, Mississippi State's always ranked in the top 20, and they always lose when they have, like, that big game. But they're always ranked, and that's in every sport. Will his offense translate into the SEC? He's not going to have the weapons immediately. But, I mean, his main thing is just plugging in that quarterback and throwing it. And, I mean, Mississippi State's known for spread run quarterbacks. our running quarterbacks or whatever. So I'm curious how that'll translate. I'd say give him a year or two to get some of his guys. Okay, do we really miss that tackle? I hope he translates. Having him's fun. Of course, I guarantee as soon as like he gets Mississippi State a top 15, top 10 team, that's when South Carolina will play him. Like every time we play Auburn, they're a top 5 team. We play LSU when they come off the national title. Guaranteed. Guaranteed Kiffin and Leach make Ole Miss and Mississippi State top 20, top 15 teams, and then that's when South Carolina play both of them. Okay. I'm getting killed on the pitch. That was Trevor Lawrence, who would find every excuse in the book. Yeah, like he did in a national title game. Yeah, he did. I don't think he saw him. I think he got cheated. Yeah, if he gets speed, yeah. I mean, he needs the receivers. The quarterback isn't necessarily a big, big deal. I mean, he needs – oh, my. Yep, there's a touchdown. I'm getting killed on that pitch. The quarterback throws to a spot. It's more about the scheme. People getting open, scheming them open. So he just, but Mississippi State doesn't have quarterbacks like that because they're always kind of big runners. Once he gets the receivers and gets his guys, they'll be fine. I think a lot of kids will want to come play for him. At Tech, he can never beat Texas or OU. Yeah, yeah, and at Washington State, they never could beat Washington. And it always seemed like when he was there, he always they would be like 8-0 or 9-0, and then they would lose that stupid game to somebody that would take them out of the Pac-12 title. Yeah, they couldn't beat Washington, and then they would always lose a stupid one. This is the point in the game where you don't want what if we fire Muschamp and hire McMuck? Yeah, I'd be done. Going into halftime. I'm curious. How McCarthy's going to he's talking about Mike McCarthy in Dallas. I'm curious how that's going to translate because McCarthy's the type that's used to having a quarterback with a big arm, a ton of great receivers, and seeing his offense for 10 plus years. He's never had a run. We never had a running game. He always relied on the pass. As soon as we got behind 7-0, it was pass all over the place. How's he going to be when he has a dominant running back and an offensive, well, although their offensive line isn't as great as it was. But, you know, how's he going to be when, let's be honest, the running back's the best player? Look who it is. What up, Ryan? He missed a pick. Okay. Now we got the gang here. Now we got the game. It's first and 10. Ball on the 28. Oh. Harris. Okay. I don't like how Harris don't like run over people. That makes it second and 8. It's got to be better. You boys can just get on and we talk. Hey, I thought about that too. If I don't feel like playing or something, we could just get on and talk some more football. That's what I want from Kevin Harris right there. This is what I want from Kevin Harris in real life too. Catch the ball, get him in open. Gets a little juke. Drags. He still got to get that touchdown though. But yeah, I agree. We should definitely get on and if I'm not gonna play, get on and we'll talk some football. I do not like this look, but we're gonna try it. Got a muscle. That brings up second and goal. curious about Kevin Harris this year. Because I think all the focus is going to be on Marshawn Lloyd, but I think Kevin Harris is going to make do with his opportunities. He's a big bruising running back. We know he's got the power. I think he's got deceptive speed. I think he can be an asset in this offense. I kind of hated they burn his red shirt, but
he splits the uprights with the extra point.
Let's go, since we got the boys here. Well, Texas Tech playing a little coastal. See how it goes. Playing a little modern warfare. Yeah, that game gets on my nerves, dude. You played a Warzone? That multiplayer gets on my nerves. What in the world? Ah, crap. Because they're bad at it. Yeah, I mean, I'm not that good at it. It's frustrating. I'm nowhere near as good at call as I used to be. What? What?
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some.
Yeah, it gets very frustrating, dude. It's extremely frustrating. I probably should sit down and play it a lot more and get used to it, but
it's second down.
I'm not like I was back in the day. I used to play the original Modern Warfare, Modern Warfare 2, Black Ops. Of course, they run. Swearinger misses the tackle. But I don't really have the patience to sit down and play. It can be fun. It can be a lot of fun, but it can be equally as frustrating very quickly. That's a big tackle. Eric Norwood. The beast.
Really good in the Modern Warfare 3 days, but this is my... Yeah, same. I haven't... This was the first call I've played since Black Ops 3.
I didn't play Infinite Warfare. I didn't play the World War 2. I didn't play Black Ops 4. So, yeah, this was the first one I picked up. And like I said, it has its moments. It can be a lot of fun. I don't play the Warzone. Yeah, Modern Warfare 3 was your game. The SB that got us in the chat, the original Modern Warfare and Modern Warfare 2, that was our heyday. That, the original Gears of War, like that was our stuff back in the day. I'm good at Frogger. you haven't played one since Black Ops 2? I played Ghost. I like Ghost. Advanced Warfare was terrible. I got that game, I think, on Black Friday the year it came out. Played it online. Everybody said like how great it was. They were going to play it with me, and then everybody stopped playing it. I played it for a few days, and then, yeah, I realized very quickly why everybody stopped playing it. It was terrible. Black Ops 3 was fun. Black Ops 3 had its moments, but I couldn't take the jumping and the moving around like they did. It was bad. Gears 2, yeah, Gears 2, that's another one. I love all the Gears. Get over his head. We got to catch that. That's got to be caught. Like with Gears, I don't play the multiplayer as much anymore. I mostly play the Horde mode, the new Escape mode. Those are my stuff. I've gotten away from a lot of PvP stuff. Like when I played Destiny, I didn't play Crucible, and oh crap, I couldn't get rid of it. Yeah, all the other calls are bad. Like what was it? So another third down. Infinite Warfare looked terrible. The World War II looked okay. This is a go the whole way. Luke Doty. Let's go. Let's get a timeout, though. That was a go the whole way. Yeah, you like that cut? Like that cut. That's what we got to have. There it is. Sidney on the slant. I don't know, maybe one of these days I'll stream Modern Warfare 2, or Modern Warfare 2, Modern Warfare, y'all can see me get destroyed and me freak out on it. That game, goodness gracious, that game. No, do not, okay, I don't know how I got out of that. Best game ever, which game? Are you asking me what's my best game ever? Second down and 10 to go. My favorite game, if you want to talk like favorite game other than maybe like Super Mario World, if we're talking about just games, not PvP stuff. Okay, I had A, but we'll take Sidney for an easy one. We'll take Sid Rice for an easy one. Luke's struggling a little bit passing, though. It's a big answer. Skyrim, no argument. Skyrim is a good one. I like that in The Witcher 3. There we go. The Tigers playing Notre Dame. That's a good one right there. Singularity, yeah. Hate that game. I would say Dead Space or Assassin's Creed 2 would be my favorites. Now, Skyrim is a good one. Somebody didn't know how to level up in that. Didn't understand how to level up in that game. I do not have a PS4. Do they? They have crossplay, but they don't have crossplay with Xbox and PS4. I have a PS4. I just don't have. Oh my! I just don't have Call of Duty for it. I want to get that Predator game for, but it's only on PS4. I want to get that Predator Hunting Grounds. Ezio. Yep. There you go. Yes, that Assassin's Creed is probably my favorite game. Why is he diving? Picked off. There we go. This Mac kid. He's 0 for 3. I'm going to try to hit them with the screen. I did not mean to flip the play. I've never played Warzone. I've actually never played a Battle Royale game. I've never played Apex, PUBG. There's the move. That could have been a disaster. Yeah, Black Flag's good. I liked Origins a lot. Odyssey, I just actually finished it. All the DLCs, they're great, and yeah, the new one's gonna be good. Vikings, I can't wait. It's definitely gonna be beast. From the 36-yard line. Yeah, if I had to pick one, I'd probably play Apex. I don't play PUBG or you know, everybody's favorite game. Okay, I just had like three people wide open. I wasn't sure who to throw it to. Let's get a timeout, boys. Pull a Spurrier. Have that amazing clock management. Throw a 5-yard pass, let the clock run down 30 seconds, then get a first down out of bounds and call timeout. That's like the Spurrier way. Oh! I didn't think I was going to get that in there. Yeah, Odyssey's a good one, but I'm telling you, that game is massive. I'm gunning it. He got the first. Let's go. Yeah, it probably should have been picked off. Let's get up to the line. He's not going to get... Oh, my. That's inexcusable. But if that was me, or them, if he hits the upright, that's... Oh. I probably... Since I got that first down, I probably should have ran up and ran the ball. Iowa State beat Iowa. There we go.
He really got a hold of that kick.
Yeah, I should have. I had the timeout in my pocket. Should have came up and ran the football. Should have ran a pound play. But yeah, definitely get Odyssey. I'm just going to warn you, it's going to take you forever to beat that game. I'm curious if the nice tackle, if the new one's going to be just as big or whatever. Because AC games have gotten massive. All right, I'm covering the edges for the pitches. And, of course, now they're going to run right up.
Tackle made at about the 27-yard line.
Need something from JB.
Always a factor in the football game.
Oh, crap. Not even close.
And they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
The defense held their ground on that play. The quarterback just wasn't able to find any open receivers.
It is pretty long. If you've played Origins, it's a lot bigger than Origins. It makes Black Flag look like... Yeah, it makes it look like a two-hour simulator. Seriously. It's massive. It makes it look like a demo. That's how big it is in scale. But I love the AC games. Definitely excited for the Vikings.
Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
Give me the... Oh, I wanted that cut back to the right. I wanted that so bad. Probably should have kept up. Yeah, I ran into him. God, I wanted that so bad. Get fired up for the new Madden, too. Yeah, Black Flag was big. Yeah, upgrading the ship, sailing and everything. Odyssey's that much... I'm telling you, Odyssey's that much bigger. I was telling one of my friends that I wanted to get on stream and just open up the game, show you the map, and then just zoom back and let you see the entire map. Because I'm not... There we go. Give me that block. You got to give me that block. Because I'd be willing to bet like the left side of the map, just a part of it, was bigger than all of Black Flag. Just in terms of like the scale. Because you have... islands and stuff you have to sail to and everything. It's a game's humongous. Origins is big, but it's not as big as Odyssey. Odyssey's one of the biggest games I've ever played. It's I remember playing the prologue, the intro of the game, the island you start. Yes. Give me this block. Luke Doty muscling. I remember like playing the intro island, the prologue, thinking, this isn't that bad. This isn't that much stuff to do. And you get a ship and leave that island and go to the next area, and then you scale back to see how big it really is. And, yeah, it was beyond overwhelming.
They'll go with a run once again. Runs it left for a decent game.
But, yeah, it's... You like Revelation? Yeah, Revelations is good. I love all the Ezio games. They re-released them. Muscle. Yeah, I wanted to get Doty a touchdown. And to be like in this and Madden where you say hut and he just falls. Wanted to actually get him a touch. Yeah, all the Ezio games are great. There we go, baby. Let's hit it. Give it to me, Reese. A tough break for Ole Miss. That means we're definitely moving up one spot. Look at that. Yeah, it has been. It has been like almost 2 weeks since I played. So everybody's enjoying the Chris streams, or I saw he's gotten a little bit better at 2K. Turn the difficulty down or whatever. Get on him. Okay. Is that like his first completion? Yeah, that's his first completion. He's getting better. No! They got him. Georgia's all of a sudden going to turn into a passing attack. He still lost the other day. Wow, that looked like one of our drops. That's brutal. That is absolutely brutal, guys. That game's rough. That game cheats. Get on him. Tackle, please. Thank you. He beat Kentucky. That's cool. They ain't get it. This is the best I've ever played against Georgia. Yeah, it is way harder. Of course, I played a franchise, dynasty, whatever it is, and I played as Milwaukee, so I had Giannis, so I could take off from the free throw line and dunk the ball every time. It wasn't fair. You'd set pick and rolls, and he'd get matched up on somebody a lot smaller, and I did X from the free throw line, and he'd go flying and dunk it. It really wasn't fair.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
This better be a bull block here. There you go.
Gains his way to the
29. The shooting is annoying. Looks awkward. I don't know. I'm not great at those games.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down mark.
You streamed last week of you playing Southern. I watched you play, played, who was it, Harvard? Oh my, I get obliterated. I saw part of it. I didn't say anything. I tuned in for like maybe less than a minute to see what it was. I saw you were playing with the team. Looked pretty cool. And get obliterated. Oh, if we get through that. He's in open space.
Situation where the quarterback knew he could pick up the first down if he kept it himself. That's a good decision.
From their own 34-yard line. First down.
Okay, this could be dirty. Do not lose the block. There you go. Kevin Harris is having a ball game, guys.
I'm just running it right at him. We're running our offense.
You have a wide open layup and miss. Yeah, see that? That's dumb. I did not. I held A. Why didn't he hand it off?
Staff is going to need to change up the blocking schemes. You can't allow the defense to play in your backfield.
I don't understand why he didn't hand it off. That was going to be ridiculous.
12 to go. Ball on the 43-yard line.
Give me blocks, Manos. There you go, baby. And Sidney runs around like a chicken with his head cut off. He blocks somebody. That's a touchdown, guys. A big Manos out front. If Sidney gets that block, that may go for a touch. Oh, well. Computer would never miss, and I couldn't make a layup. Yeah, that's... No. They're in 3-3-5. I like this. Oh! I wanted to get that wide. Wyman would have pushed him more in. I was gonna go around all of them. And Cox in control. Ah, I can't get around him. I should have spawned.
That might have actually been a situation where he should have kept it.
What do you mean a situation where I could have kept? I got obliterated. Yeah, I should have kept that. What an analysis, Herbie. He got obliterated. But if it was Trevor Lawrence.
About 4 yards away here on third down.
There's Marshawn. Get Herbie right now. This is one of those demoralizing drives where you just cram it right down their throat. There's nothing they can do. How do I have 125% red zone efficiency? Did somebody see that? Yeah, we're running the football. Yeah, it wouldn't. Yeah, exactly. It wouldn't be Trevor's fault. Never his highness's fault. Never Father Davo's fault.
We're at the 12th play of the drive.
All right. Oh, wow. That's good. I ran back to the well way too many times. That sucks. That's the end of three, though. Gamecocks up 38-14. Luke Doty with an impressive 1 yard touchdown run. We're going for this, guys. Definitely going for it when they're running a three-man front. Kevin Harris is just having a ball game. Let's go pound formation. Yeah, you can't wait to be back in Columbia. There you go. When you going back? What? How does he... I don't get that. Let's do another QB sneak.
That brings up a second and
coming to Carolina next week. Everything's pretty much about open now. God, how long does it take for him to fall? We had to get Doty some rushing touchdowns. I don't know. Kevin Harris is he could not get in. Kevin Harris is challenging now, though. This has been domination. That loss to Alabama. Look at that drive, guys. Look at that drive. That's huge. Yeah, this one's never been in. Georgia's just falling off the planet. That's huge. You'll be back in July. Everything, yeah. Everything's pretty much coming back open now.
And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback.
They're bringing some stuff back in different phases, but yeah, everything should be pretty much back open by first of next week.
The deficit is huge, but as a player, you never want to slow down your.
You could be in Florence. There you go.
The ones who aren't trying that hard.
How long are you staying for, Blake? Oh crap! Screen. Overran that. Okay. Okay, Swearinger. I even laid in for the big hit. That needs to be better. I wanted something ridiculous. We need to get Swearinger's like hit power. Because he needs to lay somebody out. I'm not happy. Mac again. Oh.
When it rains, it pours. Are you kidding me?
Get destroyed.
You're already getting blown out.
Tell him, Herbie. Tell him, Herbs. Don't talk about Father Dabo. Can't talk about it.
South Carolina comes to the line holding that commanding lead.
Okay. Man blitz. Safety looks like he's coming. Oh, my. Wyman would not break free. I should have just tried to outrun him there. That was bad. Oh, they're coming again. I could not spin. Come on. They're sticking with this man blitz. So yeah, let's run this, and if they take everybody, then we know what we're gonna do. A should be open if they don't pick him up deep.
They'll bring him down right around the 12-yard line.
Here we go. Expecting big things from these kids. Probably could have hit one of the guys on the outside, but nobody picked him up. There you go, Ryan. That's your call. Oh, you're staying a week or so, got some work at your aunt's house, play some golf, fish, drink some beer. There you go. Ah, I'm juking too late. I'm trying to hit it at that right time. I'm hitting it too late.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
All right, this is looking like a big-time blowout. Luke Doty with another one.
That's his third trip to the end zone.
I know this defense prepared for his running ability, but
what up, pups?
He's had a great day.
What up, puppy dogs? And this game could be a lot worse. Remember we threw the pick on the lob to Joiner?
And a touchdown as a result.
Fred, I thought the offense.
Yes, I threw a pick for everybody that wants to know. But no, I don't play golf. It's not really my thing. I mean, I get it, but no, I don't really play golf.
And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about
returning.
Who
is texting me?
Both teams are playing out the stretch here. You want to get experience for guys who normally don't get in the game and try to avoid injury.
Watch two.
Can we get a pass rush?
Down at the 41.
Now watch. Georgia's going to go right down the field throwing the ball. Yeah, the golf game. Yeah, playing golf on GTA. GTA 5. Could not beat that guy. Get him, JB. Okay. How does he get that off? How does he get that off? Okay, we're going to go rabbit here.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line.
I forget who we play next. I think it's A&M. Not 100% sure.
And he's tackled what? Right away.
I think it's A&M. Well, if it is, they're going to be ranked. Yeah, they come in motion. Yep. Ah, there's nobody there. Come on. You're the Garcia of golf.
That makes it first and 10.
I'm gonna leave it at that. I'm gonna leave it at that. So you have those Chick-fil-A bowl type. Yes, there's my man. Rodriguez Fitton. He's a beast. Look at that.
In the whole country.
So the sack makes this a second and long.
Have like that Chick-fil-A bowl where it was obvious he was under the influence. Couldn't hit the backside of a barn like that.
That pass didn't look
pretty much sums it up.
When it left his hand. Sometimes you don't get a great grip on the ball and it comes out a little wobbly.
Lola, I know you're fired up that we're streaming again and you want to say hello to the guys, but you got to stop being all over the laptop. Get him, JB. Okay. Okay, well, that's Eric Norwood. That's fine. I don't understand, like, Burt's not getting sacks. That's the second time. That's Eric, that's E. Norwood's first one, baby. First of many. Surprising he didn't force a fumble there.
Fourth and long here after the sack.
Puppy Dog's taking it on the chin. And my man knows what I'm going to say after this game, too. Okay. Okay. Why did he juke? Okay. That was a good run by Mr. Dak.
The offense was able to punch it in the end zone.
Because I don't show up effed up. I just get there, I play, and by the back nine, I'm hitting everything deep. There you go.
They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them.
Yeah, he doesn't block. Wow, he doesn't get that block on the edge. Wow. Oh, I had yardage. Oh, man, I had some yardage. Ah, that sucks. I'm going to slide. I was going to give him a little limp leg, but we'll go ahead and slide. I ain't getting anybody hurt. We do want to pad stats, right? Kevin Harris, baby. Glad you liked it, Nestler.
The tailback got good blocking up front and was able to pick up a bunch of yards.
From the 32-yard line. First down.
No, this time it gives it to me.
It's frustrating for this offense to go backwards, but they've just got to stick with it and know that big plays will eventually happen.
Yeah, I'm going to do a wheel right after this. I'm going to try to hit him with another screen. See how many people they're putting in the box? That's why I've been shifting the they dropped this time. That's why I've been shifting the screen. Now he blocks that guy.
And down he goes at the 27-yard line.
They've been putting so many people in the box, I wanted to hit one of those. Where is... There it is.
From the 27-yard line.
We need to get Doty one more anyway. See if we can hit... Oh, yeah, I like this. I like this.
On play action.
Oh, crap. Oh! I probably could have hit B there.
He's been over for a long time, and I'm ready for it to end. He threw that to a guy who was well covered, and it almost got intercepted.
Yeah, he's very lucky. That ball.
I was too greedy. All right.
A little over a minute in the game.
This is probably too greedy too, but. Dak, you're killing me, buddy. Oh. I could have just hit it to A, but I wanted Dak to get the catch. Oh, that's a rip.
Play callers out there, but sometimes I do think he takes it a little bit too far. I don't expect any once in a lifetime rallies here. But that being said, we could still see some
delay. Yeah, look at Norwood, baby. This is his coming out game.
Solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup.
This is coming out game for Mr. Norwood.
From their own 25-yard line.
A tough break for Wake Forest. Didn't I almost schedule them? But I wanted to play OU. Did we really miss this tackle? Look like this one. You got to go, but I'm really glad you're back. Everything's good. Appreciate it, Blake. Have a good one, buddy. We'll be on tomorrow. I'll be on tomorrow. Probably about the same. Yeah, he got three. Come on, house call. House call. Oh! It'll be tomorrow, about the same time, about 1 o'clock.
12:30,
1 o'clock.
But how about the effort and the
since I think everybody's kind of done, we'll just do – I was going to do two, but we'll just do one today. I'll save the next game for tomorrow. Yeah, Max having a ball game, boys. Three picks. Yeah, stay blitzed. Got him. K. Harris. I got one. That's why I've been running a lot of screens. They finally called him an all-out blitz. Big game for Doty. He's got, what, three passing, three rushing? That's a ball game. That is a ball game. But your man, Ryan, your man Kevin Harris, I think, is going to have a say in it, too. I still wish he hadn't got hurt in that that freaking Bama game. I got way too hesitant. Yeah, get out of my stadium. You got it. Yeah, they need to get the heck out of here. Get out of my life. I love running it up on puppies. I love South Carolina Georgia games. They're always good. Okay, that's like the third time that I think my right stick on this is messed up, because it's like every time it snaps the ball, he just flops. There you go, JB. There you go. Yep, that's right. 45 unanswered. Get out of my stadium. Get out of my life. Get out of my state. Just get out of here. That was our first touchdown. That was a good one. Doty had a slow start, kind of getting in the swing of things. But yeah, it was tied, right? It was 14-14. And then South Carolina blew it open right before the end of the half. Let's hit it. Quiet game from it was a pretty quiet game from Sydney. But we will take it. Big win. Huge win. Let's go ahead and wrap this puppy up. As Ryan said, 45 unanswered. We started off with the bomb to Dak. This was a beautiful one. I don't know why I rolled to the left. I got flushed, but you can see Dak way over there. Throwback. That was ridiculous. That was our second possession, I think it was. Then it was, let's see. Oh, no, we were up 21-7. Okay. So Georgia answered, of course, and then we kind of went back and forth. I threw that bad pick. And then, let's see, Kevin Harris with a couple of touchdowns. Georgia answered, and then we absolutely exploded right before the half. Got that pick, wanted to get seven, probably should have went and ran the football. And then Doty with three touchdown runs, and then capped it off with the screen to K. Harris. Yeah, 18-28, 305, three touchdowns, and a pick. But he did throw a pick. Kevin Harris, 153 yards, three touchdowns. Doty added 149, three touchdowns. Really good day running the football. Yeah, Kevin Harris. Look at that in the screen game. I'm telling you, Harris is going to challenge for this. Joyner only had a couple of catches. Did have a brutal drop on fourth down. Didn't really affect anything. Sidney only had a couple of catches. Really not much in the terms of the passing game. I was kind of wanting to pound the football, run right at him. Slow day for Mr. Birch. Two tackles. Had chances for sacks, just couldn't get it. How about some love in the chat for Eric Norwood, his coming out party. Four tackles, all of them for a loss, had a sack. And then Brendan Mack, the JUCO corner we got last year with three picks, almost had a house call. Look for the run game to be pretty ridiculous. Yeah, 320 yards on the ground. Georgia with 58 through the air. I don't understand that right there. 114% in a red zone makes no sense. But 320 through the air, 305 through the air, 320 on the ground. Absolutely ripped Georgia apart. 284 for them, 226 on the ground. They were 1-for-8 on third down. That was a killer. And we had the turnover margin 3-1. Look at the total yardage. This was as dominant as the score indicated. I wanted to attack them on the ground because of their alignment, 2-3 man down, and hit some big plays. Of course, when they started blitzing, I implemented more of the screen game, obviously. And Clemson was owning Notre Dame. They ended up barely hanging on. Where can I get this game where it won't cost $100? Yeah, like Ryan said, I don't think you're gonna find it for under $100, man. I really don't. It's becoming a more of a rarity. You may get lucky and find it on eBay or something, maybe, but I doubt it. I think at minimum you're gonna pay $100, just the way it is. Yeah, we do play A&M. I don't see how you're gonna get it for any less than that. Unless you just get lucky. It's just because of them not making it anymore. And, I mean, even more so now with the no sports thing. Everybody was on lockdown. Everybody's charging even more now. Yeah, it is unfortunate. A buddy of mine picked it up a few years ago, and I think he even paid like 50 or 60 for it used. And I mean, now it's went through the roof just because it's so hard to find. I mean, you're not going to be able to get it without paying, I'm afraid. Same with the NCAA Basketball 10, but this one's a bigger rarity. A lot of people want college football. Okay, how many people are ready to visit? All right, let's do this, and then we'll go ahead you guys really want me to play A&M? I kind of planned to, but I didn't know Blake was going to get off, and I kind of wanted to get back into it, the swing of things. I mean, we could save it for tomorrow and do a doubleheader. Maybe start a little bit earlier. There you go. How is he not on the list? Okay, so let's just say this. It's Doty's to lose, man. We gotta get those rushing touchdowns. I think that's what really separates them. Okay, so we're playing A&M. Stop 25 matchup. How did we not move up? I don't get that. Thought number 8 lost. So let me guess, Georgia lost. I'm going to go ahead and apologize. I'm going to go ahead and apologize for this, my man. Where's it at? That's what happened. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Georgia always gets off to a rough start on this game. Like, they always start 0-3, 1-4, something like that, and then they end up going 8-4. Yeah, I'm sorry. they did lose. Georgia switched to an option attack for some unknown reason. And, well, one thing is they ran a 2 and 3 man front, and I just decided I was going to cram the ball runner. I was going to run it right at him. And is it going to show the stats? You see the rushing stats. I ran it right at him, and then I ran the screen game, and we picked off their quarterback 3 times. He went 5 of 14 with 3 picks. It was never close after halftime. And to be honest, it probably should have been worse, but I'm sorry. I apologize. We are in really good shape with Hayden Hurst. Yeah, we bought the game the first day for 60, and then I think a week or two later it was already 40, and now you'd be lucky to find that game for double that price. Okay. We need to go ahead and get this. Oh, yeah. Look at his schedule, guys. Way to go, Garcia. Way to go, Garcia. I'm going to bring him in with him. Yeah, Garcia. He got the wrong USC, as you can see. Okay, we're good there. We got a tough schedule. This is a really tough schedule, but I'm okay with it. We're in good shape. I'm playing Oklahoma in the season because I played them. This is my 4th year. We've made the national title all 3 times and played Oklahoma all 3 times. We should have played Oregon last year, and they lost in the Pac-12 title game. And I'm tired of playing Oklahoma, so I scheduled them. And if they still make it, I mean, if I lose that game, okay, we cannot. We're gonna bring him here. Because we're good there. Yeah, if I lose the game, then obviously I probably won't make it. But if I beat Oklahoma and they make it again, I think I'm done. I'm tired of playing Oklahoma. I'm seriously just tired of playing them. Let me see. All right, you guys want another one? Do we want another one? We want to save it for tomorrow. I mean, I can do 2 tomorrow. It's up to you guys. I mean, I think we definitely back into it. Let me see the... Herbie's actually picking us. We lost that tough one to Alabama. It'll be like my first season on this game. When the game first came out, I did my first season. I remember I destroyed with Brandon Wilds. I went 12-0, beat everybody during the regular season, lost to Alabama in the SEC title game, barely lost at the end, had to play in the Capital One Bowl. I was so furious. Was 12-1 and had to play in the Capital One Bowl. I was ranked number 5. I was so aggravated. So you see this next stretch, right, guys? I mean, we could save it and play A&M and OU. I'm playing OU tomorrow. So, I mean, we could do A&M and OU tomorrow. We could do OU and Kentucky. This is a big stretch here, and then it eases up, and then, yeah, 2 out of the last 3. This is we play number 3, 4, 5, 7, 2017, and 22. That's ridiculous. LSU wasn't ranked. We struggled in this game. That was the last game I played. I remember we pulled away late. Eh, the heck with it. Let's do it. Doing black pants, though. Just so everybody's okay with that. We're doing black. Let's do it. Let me get a water while this starts, and we will take on the Aggies. How are they a 99? Everybody's a 99 now because of the progression.
Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show.
Gotta go. All right, Ryan, take it easy, buddy. We'll see you tomorrow. Of course it rains. Well, I got my Spurs up guy here. He's sticking it with me.
Doesn't wait to turn up the intensity. An early season matchup in the Southeastern Conference. We've done all we can do here.
Okay. Yeah, you know, that's the problem, though. We have to beat Florida. Because we're already behind the eight ball, losing that first game. I played Bama, what, five times the last three seasons? Because I have to play him twice. And I always start off with him. This is the team I want to beat.
Texas A&M is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kick.
We never can beat them.
He sends this one deep. Signals for a fair catch. South Carolina's offense really.
All right, big game from Luke D today. We need it.
Fred, over the weeks I've been watching him.
Oregon's number two. It'll probably lose again at the end, right?
I mean, time after time, he just avoids the mistakes. And you can do that as a quarterback and as a leader of an offense.
I just wish they would update this game.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field.
Put it on next-gen consoles. Ah.
Up the middle for a nice game. Lloyd gains about 5 yards on the run. That brings up second and five. From their own 30-yard line, it's second down.
Bring Lyman under here. See if the linebacker drops, which of course he does. Little Kevin Harris with a little juke. Yeah, you hate A&M. I'm tired of A&M. We can't beat them. We're just not able to beat them. Played them close a few times.
That's one of the reasons why he's putting up numbers that are among the nation's elite.
I mean, that game we played them this year. Oh, wow. Oh, wow. It was at the last second. Wow. We lost, what was it, 30-6, but that game was 17-3 most of the day. We had no offense. Yeah, why don't they remaster it? I don't know. They don't. They can't talk about it. Oh, okay. I wish they would. I really wish they would, man. It'd be beast. Even if they just, like, touched up the graphics and gameplay, updated the rosters, updated the jerseys and the stadiums, the conferences, you know, little stuff, the game would sell like hotcakes. I guarantee it. It would fund the next game for them to go all out with a new engine and everything. I mean, they could use the same engine, just touch it up. Last time we played them, we lost by one score and they blocked two field goals and ran a punt in. That sounds about right. That sounds like Texas Tech in a nutshell. I don't know if they don't have the rights. I don't, they're waiting on that case to see about giving compensation. But, I mean, just release a game with random people. Yeah, that's what you mean. The right for player likeness, yeah. I mean, that's the big hurdle with this game. Right there, my man Sidney. I had a couple of people open. We'll take Sidney there. Yeah, put Lawrence on the cover. Yeah, he'll be. It'll be a picture of Herbie and Dabo. Sharp before this one even started. From the 29-yard line, first down. NCAA football, Father Dabo's Bible verses. There it is. Outrun him. To the one. Does he always get to the one? So when you can toss one up like that for a big completion, it can boost your confidence. Catching some people on some blitzes today. Cannot get that touchdown. How did he not score?
First and goal from the one, looking to punch this one in. They line up in the jumbo set.
All right, the no excuse formation. He gets a yard, but we don't score, right? Oh, well, whatever. We'll get Marshawn Lloyd one. Pretty solid hole. Big start. Setting up a top 10 matchup tomorrow with OU. All right. Let's go. Give it to me, Reese. Oh, there's a tough one. This would be a tough one. Let me guess. Let me take a guess. A&M runs the option too. If Jimbo's still there, they don't. There we go. There'll be more. This should be the most traditional team I play. If that's humanly possible. JB, and this is also the game JB should have make a living.
So that sack leaves them with some work to do. It's third down and 14.
Yeah, who runs hurry? Yeah, I don't. That's the name of this game. Everybody runs hurry up. Run an option. You run a hurry up. Get him. He's gonna. If he would have. All right, big three and out to start. But if that was me, you would have dropped it.
Scruggs awaits the snap.
Scruggs.
They get this one off and it's a beauty.
Solid block.
The 20-yard line. Well, that was a great punt, and there was even better coverage on the return.
What's the over-under of rushing you think's going to be in that Bama-Georgia game? They both run the option.
To maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting All right. points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up.
Crap.
For them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
South Carolina's got a guy behind center that can really do it all, Herbie. I mean, he's a dual threat. He can hurt you with his feet and his arm.
He'll do it all.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20. South Carolina is up by a touchdown.
Oh, I thought he's going to back off. I got to get Sidney and Dak the ball. These are the ones that make our offense go. Okay. He didn't get let me see what they line up in.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here.
Little pound formation.
I really would have expected
yeah.
this ball. He gets out to about
going for that.
Not much
what am I playing online?
He picked up some tough yardage.
Well, nothing fancy here. The back did a nice job of putting his head down and getting the first down.
OU, now watch. I schedule OU to ensure they don't go undefeated. They'll lose right before I play them.
They'll bring him down right around the 46-yard line.
Watch. Watch that happen.
From their own 46-yard line, it's first down.
I'm going to count on them to blitz because they're going to be running a man out here. Okay, with the cutback, Sidney Rice, get destroyed. That wasn't the way I designed it, but we'll take it. Let's go. Sid Rice said I want to get him the ball more. There we go. All right. Boom. Let's hit it. Give it to me, Reese.
Yeah, nobody cares. Game's bad.
All right.
Been beaten soundly on both sides of the ball, and we haven't even gotten to the second quarter.
Okay. I think that one to Sydney may get clipped later. Texas Tech playing Troy. I don't get y'all's schedule. Let me guess, leave South Carolina and take over Tech on this, right? Alright, I need to get out of this 3 foot. What? Nice tackle. I need to get out of this formation. Texas State will lose by 50 to Tulane. They are bad. I like this Stevens. You don't understand his Baylor Cup. Was he Cooper Cup's brother? Better not be the Georgia-Alabama game. Get on him. Okay. Oh, my, this Cup. He's going to be like that Hancock kid on Texas. Oh, crap. Almost jumped off sides. Oh, my. I cannot get out of this formation. Now I can get out of it. That handcuff. Now all of a sudden A&M's just not stopping. Watch them run this to the left. Yep. That's the end of the quarter. At your Marshawn Lloyd for a touch. At JB with a sack. Hit Sydney on a. That was ridiculous. Wasn't the way it was drawn up, but we will take it. All right, defense.
We're ready for more football here in quarter number two.
Check curls. Get on him. There's a corner for the touchdown. Yep. I was guarding the out routes. Got burn on that one. Why were two people standing there side by side? Knew it was about time for the defense to give up something.
He makes the PAT. A nice 7-play, 74-yard drive. And it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
Texas A&M. Get set to kick this one away.
And down he goes. Going to go Amos. I'm going to go off tackle.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much.
They overloaded that side.
South Carolina up 7 points.
What? Hey!
To about the 33.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards. First down.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33.
Let's. Stacking the block. Nope, they dropped. I feel like our running game is just too powerful. The only team I can't really they're blitzing at safety. The only team I can't really like pound is Bama. The only team I can't do it against consistently.
From their own 45-yard line. First down. Got an opening. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
All right. Gain of 8 on the play. Boy, that looked like holding there. All right, I'm going to take a deep shot. No safety in the middle of the field. I can't. God bless. Add X. I just had no time. I took too long to set up. Man, it took too long to set up.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks.
Sydney. I'm on their side of the field. Don't really want to punt from here. I'm a little nervous about. See what they line up in.
South Carolina is up 7.
See what they line up in. They're coming.
Tailback. He's tackled. 37-yard line.
Whew. I was debating on taking the delay of game there. Dang it. I just wasn't sure what to do. I could have punted, but they'll punt it out the stadium if I did that. But I was nervous. No, we did. Nobody blocks. Come on. Nobody blocked him. Look at this. Look at that.
I hope they don't call you out because you're going to get embarrassed on Monday on that one.
It was a good block. I thought it was solid. Man blitz again. What is with them with the blitz? Keep them all in the block. Because there's going to be no. The safety did drop.
He gets rid of this one.
I thought the safety was going to come up. I thought I was going to have that to Dak. I'm going to end up having a punt anyway.
The sub package in there defensively.
Okay, I'm bringing Dak across this to get in field goal range. Hold on to the ball. It's all I ask.
I know the defense would have liked to have prevented such a big game, but the important thing
I was just trying to get in field goal range. 10-mile-an-hour wind.
Kicks up.
Get owned. That's big.
In the studio with this update. Reese,
wait till you see the action in Athens. This is a game we've been.
That would be the Georgia thing to do.
And for Alabama, all the ingredients look as if they are starting to fall into place for a potential upset.
That's big. Alright. Pass rush needs to start getting there on
first quarter, but I wouldn't be
what's his name? Oh, that was what I was worried about. Okay. Okay. That Spiller kid, he's got to be a senior. Oh, my, he ran into his own man. I went to go pick it off. He pushed his own man. Oh crap. Oh crap. Hang on just a second, guys. Let me see. I just heard something. Let me see. I think somebody was at the door. All right, sorry about that. I just heard like a door or whatever. It was loud. It was bamming on the door. All right. Okay, that's a touchdown. Yeah. We're getting. I'm getting absolutely gashed now. They switch from traditional under center offense to quarterback runs. Yeah, I got you. I got him that time. Sick of this kid.
That brings up second and goal. That brings up a second and goal. 6 yards to the end zone.
Now they come under center. Tackle. Nice tackle. Really nice tackle. Okay.
Comes out in a 4-4. They need a big play here.
Third and goal, boys. Ah!
Zips it to the tight end. Touchdown, A&M.
Ah, that's a rip. This cup. He's 8-for-8.
Draw within a field goal.
That's unfortunate.
And he tacks on the extra point.
Now I got to get points before the half.
75-yard drive. And they put up 7 points.
You know, this offensive line has done a really good job, but really, I think it's more about the big play ability from the running backs and why we've seen so many big plays from this offense.
He just drills this one. Heading for the corner.
Good block. Oh!
The Gamecocks right now are getting the play out of their quarterback that they expected, maybe even better than they expected. And now, as we get near halftime, there's going to have to be some adjustments made on the other side of the ball.
Well, the defense has got to be happy we're getting close to halftime so they can go back to the drawing board and try to figure out a way to slow down this quarterback. I think that more often than not, you look back.
Try to throw the ball here.
About, okay, let's eliminate this, this, and this, and let's maybe try a completely different way of trying to attack them. In my opinion, they've got to take some chances.
I probably hit right bumper. I cannot get that spin.
So far, hasn't worked. Williams on the tackle at the 46-yard line. That makes it second and six. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Ready, ready, team.
Oh, wow. Can't make that throw.
Just throws this one away.
Can't make that throw.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48.
Oh, look at Iowa State.
South Carolina is up by three.
Give me that block. No. Okay. Whew. Thought he's going to get stopped short. I'll get 98 Weasel. Get by him.
That makes it second and 10. Two minutes to go in the half.
Here we go.
He scrambled.
Gotta get Kenyon going too. I forgot about Kenyon.
He ran a good route there and was able to pick up yards underneath the coverage.
It's okay to move the ball in small portions because it relaxes the offense and can open things up for the big play.
Yes.
And they make the stop at the 31-yard line.
Gain of 11 on the play. That makes it first and 10.
It's the issue with this team is I have so many players that I want to get the ball to. Bogged down there.
They need to hurry here.
Well, you'd think so, but there doesn't seem to be much urgency on the field right now.
I don't want to give A&M any time because I think they get it first. Give me that block.
Touchdown.
Muscle. Yeah, so much for giving him time. Oops. Wrong play. Let's go Luke Doty, baby. Alright. Gah, somebody got pancake. And Cox up by 10. That's a big drive for Luke D. Game got a little tougher than it should have been, but back up by two possessions.
Of distance.
I believe this game was 14-0, looking like we were cruising. Ah, crap. Let's go back. Let's go back here.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points
get
up on the
board. Him. What?
He's under pressure.
What? Okay.
And he stopped behind the line.
What in the world? Mike should have called timeout there.
We've got second and long. Ball on the 17.
Yeah, there goes Bama. Good on. Now I'm gonna call timeout.
You know, the reason why this guy gets all the honors, it's because he makes great plays like this look routine.
Yeah, they're gonna run now. Yeah, definitely. You know, I was about to say.
South Carolina's gonna have to use their second time out of the half.
I was about to say.
Do not cheat me on that game. Yeah, when he broke that tackle. When he broke that tackle, I was like, here we go. Usually how it works. Just get down the one time he doesn't get he gets the spin that time. All right, this is just one shot. Just chunking one in the end zone and see.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Yeah, had he got that, I was done. No, no.
Got his man, and down he goes at the 38. We played a half of football.
Oh, I wanted that block. If he didn't get caught, I was wanting him to catch that and run with that block.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin.
All right, defense. Gotta be better second half. Gotta be a lot better. Oh my. So much for the defense. He just breaks through. Here we go. Never fails.
Here's the extra point to draw within 3 points. And he adds
what the heck?
Reese Davis is standing by with this update. Reese,
give it to me, Reese.
The Crimson Tides roll into today's game ranked third in the nation. Let's take another peek at this game. The Crimson Tides.
It's gonna be a shootout.
On the ground, and they find Pater.
Unbelievable right now. I think our trash people have finally showed up.
With the offense ready to get things going again.
To pick up our trash finally. Oh my, I thought he blocked him. I was looking ahead. I thought that was going to be like a 20, 30 yard run. He didn't block him. I was looking up at the second level. Got him. I did this to them last year. Yeah, that's what you get. That makes up for that stupid kickoff return. Mike Wyman. A&M knows about man blitz. A&M can tell you exactly what happens when you man blitz.
Some sense of urgency to this offense right now.
Yeah, Oklahoma's pulling away, so yeah, we'll have the top 10 matchup tomorrow. Well, provided we get out of this one.
Just throws this one away.
That's his first incompletion.
The worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Do we really not have a matchup there? Another screen.
Quick throw.
And we don't get off the block. To this fullback.
At the 36.
You don't always need to throw the ball with a lot of zip, although it does help in some cases.
We just could not get there.
Like this guy, you can make all the throws.
That's a good play call to the fullback. Oh my, this cup. Watch him run left. Yeah. Get there?
The middle for a nice game.
They got me off balance. Oh, we had him. That's why I like that Stevens kid. That kid's so fast on the edge.
Switch.
Get him, Birch. We got him. They may go for this. Nope, maybe not. They're kind of in no man's land. That's a huge stop. Virginia, Florida State. Okay. Okay. I'm at the 20. Fair enough.
Last time out, they were able to pick up big chunks of yards through the air. You wonder if they'll go back to that.
This has to be the drive right here.
They start to lean a little bit more on their ground game.
Oh, God, he ran into me. That was dangerous, but. Oh, I thought that was it. I saw him break free at the last second. Oh, man, he was open for it. Man, I wanted that. There we go. We got to get Kay Harris going, too. I got so many people I want to get the ball to. Let's get this first down. Just muscle.
From their own 32-yard line. First down.
Let's get Dak across the field. I like the way they're lined up.
They try running left.
There we go. Ah. Oh, there we go. There's the play call. Got the big block. Finally.
Man left, man left. Four down. Mike 36.
All right. Okay. I was going to get destroyed regardless. We'll just take the little game.
Experience really showed on that run. He sniffed it out perfectly and made the tackle.
Oh, he did?
From the 27-yard line. It's second down.
Middle of the field's wide open still. Solid block. Oh, my.
It can damage a team's confidence.
This is a what a block right there. Goodness. Go back. Hit Sydney on the outside here. Actually, he's not even in the game. No! Didn't get enough air under it. That was bad. Gotta get more air. I didn't even hold it down. Dang it.
So the kicker comes out.
I'm kicking into the wind. Yeah, he drilled it anyway. Good thing is I'll have the win for the fourth quarter.
Smith is deep to receive, and look out, folks. He's looking to run another one back for six.
Yeah. Talk about it. I wanted that pass to Wyman on the edge, but I needed more air under it.
The Gamecock staff has got a winner on their hands. You've been around.
Doty 1 for 3, 71 yards.
I think it's infectious. His attitude, I think, permeates throughout this entire offense and really
throughout defense.
The entire team. It's no wonder okay. The team is so good.
Okay.
At the front.
Joyner got hurt on that speed sweep.
The last time they had it, they'll be looking for a little more.
Great.
On this possession.
Down two possessions. This
no, I hit the wrong button. Get him, Mac. Yeah, he's impact now.
The 27-yard line. So it's complete, but they didn't get
after his three-pick performance.
Just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
Oh, my. He missed. Great.
He goes down.
Getting gashed. Thought we were going to be in position to make that play.
Quick throw. And they push him out right around the 30.
This is going to be a one-possession game. That was my chance to really, really put the distance between us. I messed that up. That's a big tackle by Birch. Because that dude was off and running if he doesn't make that tackle. Be a pitch out. What? Oh, I hit start by it. Woo! Thank you. Guess who it is again? Max got to make that tackle, but at least he slowed him down. That's a huge, huge third down stop.
Looks long enough.
He missed! That's huge. Yeah, Bama's pulling away now. Alright. Now we got the chance to blow this one open. Oh! Alright, no more screens today. They're not working nowhere near as much as they were against Georgia. Second down. It was the perfect game. Give me some blocks. Probably could have stayed out. Who calls the screen on first down? Oh, they're thinking I'm going to run and they blitz. There we go. There we go. Why not, you know? I scored off of it last game with a screen on first down. They think I'm going to run. They call a run blitz. Okay. Ah! What? Then he spins again. All right, let's see. Beat the pass blitz. I know, dear, but still can catch him. Oh my! If they're blitzing, it still can catch him. Is my point. But it hasn't really worked but once maybe this game. Oh, great. Yeah, I can't. Yeah, couldn't get away from it. Yeah, I mean, yeah, exactly. In the game, they're the exact same. They blitz, they blitz. There's that dumb kickoff return. I got to kick another field. This time I got the win.
Kicks up.
Boom.
South Carolina ready to kick this one off.
There we go.
He got all of that one. And they can forget about returning this one.
But they haven't, I guess the thing is they haven't attacked me like Georgia did. Georgia was blitzing like crazy. I was able to get to the second level a lot. I'd catch it and have so many blockers out for... Okay. This one, they're not. A&M's dropping when I do it. I think I hit him one time. I mean, I scored off of a screen, but that was more because I cut back with their wide receiver. Second down. Oh! Alright, defense. No excuse.
He throws it. That's a great.
Oh, my. He hangs on. Those freaking corner routes. That's perfect. That was a perfect pass. I got there as it got there. Nah! He made up for it, though. Oh! And he gets obliterated. EJ Swearinger. Everybody says this kid's a real deal. We're about ready to find out. Yeah, that's what they get. Going back to it. See, that's usually why, because a lot of times they run that zone blitz on first down where they bring that corner. Okay. Just to catch him. Now they go cover two. No, he didn't. Yep. I knew that was going to happen. Yeah, I knew that was going to happen eventually. And there's the Madden effect. About to blow him out. I couldn't get away. There's the Madden. Right, just about to blow him out. Ah.
Football is about how you respond to adversity. Moving forward after a turnover is a perfect example of that.
Oh, with the Heisman now. Here we go with the Heisman. Just about to blow this game wide open. And now it starts. Oh, he's wide open. That fullback slipped out. God, he was wide open. I don't think he could have thrown that, though. I don't know how that kid got so open. I didn't realize I had two impact corners. Birch didn't even impact. Oh, my. Yeah, they're going to get this touchdown now. They're going to get this touchdown now. A&M's done nothing second half except for that kickoff return. I don't understand. Yep, touchdown. Can't stop him now. That fumble, that's what started it. Looked like I was getting ready to blow him out.
So the offense is going to go for two.
All right, we need to stop. You didn't get it. That is huge. 62-yard drive, but the failed two-point conversion keeps a 6-point score. It stays a 10-point game.
Texas A&M is ready to kick it away.
Yeah, they're kicking into the wind. Solid move.
See how the offense rebounds after fumbling on their last possession.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that.
We could get through that.
Gains around 3 yards on the run.
Haven't really dominated with Harris. I think the opportunities have been there, but
it's second down.
Yeah, they overloaded this side. Oh!
Lloyd picks up about 4 yards on the play.
I ran ahead of the block there. Dak being out doesn't help either. Yeah, Georgia was up 10-7. Solid. That's 31-10.
And he carries the ball for a nice game.
I'm going to go back to that jet sweep. I got speed on the field with it. Go to the wide side.
Ball on their own 29.
If Harris blocks that safety. I should have stayed out. They got strung out too fast. Dang it. Thought we could get that. Dak probably could have because Dak's a lot faster.
slides down to the ground.
Yeah, we're definitely going to slide when I can with Doty. No, I don't want that. This could be a handoff.
Yardage situation here. It's third and one.
Nope, nobody. Oh, he blocked. Oh, wow, that kid came free. I didn't think we were going to get through. Dang it. I did not think I was going to get through. There we go.
At the 48. That's good for a gain of 11 yards. First down. And this is the eighth play of the drive.
This is a keep the ball on the ground, run the football. They're going to blitz. Still running. Yes.
Lloyd picks up about 7 yards on the run. That'll bring up second and three.
All right, I want to... That's not the right formation. We get this jet sweep on the side.
Here on second down.
All right, I like this look.
He'll get it again.
Oh, that kid's just so fast. God, that guy's so fast. Trying to get him on the edge. That play is there. It's just a matter of getting him on the edge. We did it once.
Less than 3 minutes in the game. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
God, 281 on the ground.
That makes it first and 10. From the 30-yard line, first down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That's good for a game of 7 yards.
Texas A&M's going to take their first time out of the half. This is the 12th play of this drive.
All right, 2:16 to go. Just keep, just muscle. Yes. This is all this is. Nothing fancy about it. Just running it right at him.
You know, this offense isn't hitting a lot of big plays, but they're very, very
consistent
with their execution. It's putting a lot of pressure right now on this defense.
To the block, Manos.
It's first down.
Probably could have went wide there, but
so the Aggies are going to have to call their third and final timeout.
Well, let's go.
This is the 14th play of this drive.
All right, they're out of timeouts. Kevin Harris.
To
the one.
Now is giving up a lot of plays. It's been a very methodical drive here by this offense. 6 first downs on this drive alone. But the defense can't give up. I know they're tired. I know they're frustrated. But if they can hold this offense to a field goal,
I'm actually okay if he gets tackled for a loss here. This is just about power football. I'll let this clock run. I'm okay with that. I'm okay with that.
No gain. That brings up second and goal.
I'll do it again.
Second down.
I'm okay with this because this runs the clock like crazy. Now we bulldozed. Yeah, that chewed up like a minute. just off of that. That was the, that's the killer right there. And the fact they didn't get that two. Yeah, look at that. 16 plays, 75-yard drive. Took two-thirds of a quarter. That'll do it. That'll do it right there. That's your exclamation point. Ole Miss is ranked 15, 1-1. All right, up by 17 now.
Nice kick, plenty of distance.
Them not getting that two is big. Now we're up by three possessions. All right. Crap, that's not what I wanted. It's not what I wanted either. There we go. All right, rabbit pack is the rest of the game.
See the clock hit zero. A comeback is just not happening. Under a minute left.
They come out two tight ends for some reason, just because. Yeah, just because.
From their own 25-yard line, it's second down.
Stanford's number eight. They're going to stay. Bama's definitely going to stay where they're at. But it's okay, though, because, I mean, we play two top five teams. We play three teams that are ranked ahead of us. So we're going to be okay. Getting back in it. Get him. Don't let him get the first. That's big. Yeah, that just kills even more clock.
That'll make it second and inches. Ready, black and black. The spike will stop the clock. Spikes the ball.
That'll bring up third and inches. Yeah, I'm in great shape.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the
first All right. down. Yeah, OU should be interesting tomorrow. We blew them out the year before last. Beat them in overtime the first time. Yes! That'll pretty much do it. JB, getting tired of it. Wondering why he's not impact. Yeah, no, punt the football.
Scruggs to punt.
I'm going to stand Scruggs. Hopefully we get a couple of commitments after this. I mean, a couple blocks. What do we not do?
Well, Brad, early it looked like there was an opening there, but the
I mean, do you take a shot here? Just cuz, or do we throw that pick? I understand man zone. Just give me time.
Doty on play action.
Yeah, take him away.
He's to the 40. He goes out of bounds.
Oh, that's just too easy. Just take him away. That's all you got to do.
From their own 41-yard line.
Now, Doty with a solid game. See if we can add a pick to that resume today. Oh, crap. Yeah, well, that's how it end. It was a good block. Big 44-27 dub in College Station. Yeah, we definitely got to enjoy Doty. I didn't play Sandstorm most of the second half. Big game from Luke D. Definitely a big game. Keeps him in the Heisman conversation. I think Kevin Harris had a low-key good game. A little closer than it should have been. It was a little closer than it should have been. That was the big one. We were up 14-0, and then the next thing you know, it was, what, 17-14? And then that, he broke through like five people. He was gone right there. I had nothing I could do about that. That was the only thing that kept A&M in it. And then I was up, what was it, 37-21 and fumbled. And that was our lob to Wyman. It was a good blitz. So, solid game. Doty with some big plays.
Let's go ahead and wrap the statistics up and wrap this puppy up today. Looked like we were going to blow it open. Had that beautiful drive that started, stopped them three and out, hit Sydney on the screen, cut back, he was gone. Of course, A&M went right down the field and answered. We got the field goal. A&M scored again. Then we got the touchdown right before the half to go up 24-14 at half. And then, of course, A&M just runs the kickoff back just because we answered with the lob to Wyman. And then had to settle for some field goals. Could not. We kept getting around in the 20 near the red zone. Had to settle for some field goals. Looked like we were just about to blow this game wide open. It was 37-21, and we picked him off. We fumbled. A&M went right down the field, scored. And then we had that long, demoralizing drive to end it to go up by 17. Doty, not spectacular, 15 of 23, 247, no picks. Where we did our damage was on the ground. 17 carries, 119 yards. He did have that fumble. It was a little unbearable. Kevin Harris, 122 yards today. Marshawn Lloyd, 37. Tried to get justice on the sweep like we did with Dak. Dak had that really nice speed sweep. Harris really couldn't get much. I think we had the one nice screen. Joiner, just not much. Morris had a couple of catches. Sydney with the big one on the screen. Wyman had a big catch. Really not getting the receivers going a whole lot, but they are making do with what they're making do with what they catch. Birch returned to form. 8 tackles, 5 for a loss, 2 sacks. That was the only sacks. Swearinger had the pick after he gave up a third down. Pretty good. We did have the one turnover, the fumble. Total yardage, 564 to 340. They had 175 on the ground to our 317. 247 to 165. Actually, both teams perfect in the red zone. We had to settle for some field goals right outside the red zone. I said both teams had turnovers. They had the big kick return that gave them more, a lot more yardage there. So 44 to 27. Let's clean up the recruiting, and then we will set it up for tomorrow. A big top 10 matchup as the OU Sooners are coming to Columbia. Darn, Ole Miss won a big shootout, 42 to 40. Everybody's getting in shootouts. I understand Ron Roberts is our defensive coordinator. Okay, question is do we move up? There it is. That's the big one for tomorrow. So, yeah, rematch with OU tomorrow, a rematch of last year's national championship game. Gamecocks have pulled off 3 wins in a row over LSU, Georgia, and A&M to get back into, well, with 3-1 in the SEC as well. Look at there. There we go. Hey, there you go, boys. Hayden Hurst. Okay, I'm about done with Gars. See where we're at with the recruiting. We'll clean this up. Here it is. We still cannot move up. Thanks a lot, Herbs. Oklahoma's offense is kind of bad. They're kind of bad on offense. Huh. That's interesting. Make sure, yeah, A&M dropped out of top 25. Let's make sure my man, Luke D. Yep. Look at that. Wow. Oh, that's going to kill me if he wins it, guys. Oh, that is a killer. Oh, man. Wow. That one stings. That one still stings. All right. I don't get Garcia. All right, he's coming to visit. This is our chance to take over Southern Cal. Yeah, scholarship is offered. He probably is. He's going to come drunk. I mean, you know he is. That right there is going to get on my nerves. Okay, we're good there. We're good there. Let's bump this up to make sure we're good there. Bump this up. I think we're good there. I think we're good there. We're real good. Okay. Hold on, we haven't, Oh, there you go. Well, there you go. That's your 5-star. That was fast. That was real fast. We'll take it. Aiden Hurst, the man. There are a lot of quarterbacks. You know I like D. Lyman. Let's see. Okay, he's really not that good. Okay, get off my board, please. He's not terrible. Get something real quick. We do lose two defensive ends. We need a tackle. Yeah. Let's go ahead and get this kid. So that'll do that. We need to get another defensive tackle. We'll work on that later. Yeah, he's pretty decked out now. All right, so that is gonna do it for me. Welcome back, everybody. Glad to be back. We'll get back into it tomorrow. About the same time, about 12:30, 1 o'clock. If you have not followed for notifications, please do so. And we will catch you guys about the same time tomorrow. We'll take on Oklahoma. I think we have Oklahoma and Kentucky. I think is what our schedule is. Yeah, we got Oklahoma. Kentucky lost. So, yeah, we'll take on. They've beaten Georgia and TCU. God, Georgia's had it rough. Texas is back, right? Okay, so that'll do it for me. We'll do it tomorrow, Oklahoma, Kentucky, doubleheader. And good to be back, guys. We'll talk to you tomorrow.